Good afternoon. I want to take this opportunity to welcome you to Great Plains Lutheran High School for our annual spring concert. Hopefully the traveling conditions were a little bit better today than they might have been a couple weeks ago had we tried this on kind of a nasty weather weekend. Also want to welcome our viewers who might be tuning in online. This afternoon our students are looking forward to, are honored and privileged to, sing the mighty power of God. We would pray that their message would be a blessing to you this afternoon. Enjoy the concert. Thank you.
While they're moving around before the final two anthems on the concert, I just want to say a couple of thank yous. Thank you to the students who helped get things set up, the streaming, the sound, and the chairs and everything that we needed for today. Additionally, thank you to the faculty and staff and administration, office, help, everyone here for allowing us the time to get together. We did have some additional time, however, a week of it was spring break, plus I didn't return from BandFest until Tuesday, so we had about 4 days, which is about two rehearsals for each ensemble. So we did have a little bit of extra time to get a few things ironed out, and we appreciated that. So thank you for coming, and enjoy our final two anthems. Also, thank you, Deanna, for accompanying.
Again, we thank you for coming this afternoon. We pray that the power and love of God that our students declared will uplift your faith as you continue to journey through Lent to that victory celebration of Easter that's coming up in a few weeks. In addition to the words of thanks that Mr. Martin's already said, the one that we still need to say is to Mr. Martin's for your tireless effort and leadership in pulling off today's concert. We very much appreciate your efforts, all the efforts of the people that Mr. Martin's already thanked. Let's give them a round of applause. By all means, stick around and mingle, but we'll be transitioning to our winter awards banquet in the next 10 minutes or so. If you could provide a little bit of help, you can see that the nearest tables to us still need chairs so that we have enough seating for everybody for the banquet. A little bit of help moving some chairs over. But otherwise, we'll ask the parents and relatives that are sticking around for the banquet to move over to these tables and chairs, and we'll get that going in a few minutes. Again, thank you for coming this afternoon. Have a safe drive home.
to the floor. For those of you that are sticking around for the winter banquet, could you make your way over towards the tables, and we'll be getting started in about 2 minutes. All right, I think we are going to begin our 2018-2019 Winter Awards Banquet. First of all, thanks for everybody that's come out. With the delay, as mentioned at the end of the concert, it maybe feels like this is a little bit more distant past than recent things that have been going on, but I think it was a good decision to not need people to travel in all the snow and bad conditions of the storms a couple weeks ago. A couple things to draw your attention to before we get into the specific presentations of the activities. I want to start with a few thank yous, and some of these are repeats. If you've been to these before, they are ones you've heard before, but they're very important to begin with. My first thank you goes to you parents, those of you that are able to be here today, those of you that are watching online. I am never not impressed with the amount of dedication that you parents put towards your child's education, to their opportunities that they get here at Great Plains. The amount of miles that are traveled to go and watch them participate in their events, the amount of support that you give to them, to us teachers, as you entrust your children to our care, is something that is something we do not take lightly, and we consider it a great privilege to get to work with you in training your children to be the next generation of Christian adults. So thank you for all the miles, thank you for all the support, thank you for all the words of encouragement that you give to our faculty members, to our students, to your children's friends, and also to your children as they continue their walk with God. So thank you, parents. Officials love working GPL games. It's not because the games are running clock and they end faster and they make more money per hour. It's because of the people that they get to work with in the games. I take great pride in the people that volunteer to work our games, to run the scoreboard, to officiate SEA games, to run the tickets, to run the concession stand, all the people that make our operation a first-rate operation. So thanks to our faculty and our volunteers that make our games, especially our basketball games this season, a great success. So thank you to all of our helpers. Thank you to our coaches, both our head coaches and our assistant coaches, our directors and helpers. The amount of time and dedication that you commit to these student athletes to show them the passion that you have for these activities and to give them an opportunity to learn, to grow, and to experience success is awesome. The amount of dedication that you give, the amount of time that you take out of your own personal life, out of your professional life, to give to our student athletes is outstanding. I'm very, very proud to call myself one of you and to work with each and every one of you. So thank you to our coaches. Much more behind the scenes, and maybe not even wanting to get any recognition even here, but they deserve recognition are our office ladies. The ones that work tirelessly to put the programs together, to share things online and social media and emails so that you know when all of the crazy cancellations and postponements were happening. It's truly a great opportunity to thank them for the tireless work that they do to make our operations run so smoothly. So for Janine and Karen and Liz, and all of their helpers, thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you to our transportation service, primarily Carla, also Mr. Bauer this year. I believe we were able to go through an entire winter without any major travel stories, which is an awesome gift from God. So thank you for your service to our programs in that capacity. Thanks to our students that are tech savvy that can put the live streams together so that parents can watch their children regardless of their schedules or the distance that separates them from GPL. I think it's a truly great blessing to be able to watch those kids, your kids, participate in their activities. Not every one of our activities is licensed to be live streamed, but we live stream everything we can. And for those individuals that set up the programming, the ones that run the cameras, and to our announcer, Mr. Rodewald, I'm very grateful for the work that you put in for our basketball season. So thank you specifically also, Nathan, for putting all the programming together. Thank you. And the last one, to our student athletes. Thank you for using your talents. Thank you for trying your best at these activities, whether it's your favorite activity in the whole school year or something you were just trying for the first time. Thank you for your time management skills, for your teamwork, for your dedication to yourself and for your programs. It's a very awesome thing to call yourself a Panther student athlete, to be able to keep your grades up in the classroom and to use your abilities in all the different ways that we're going to celebrate tonight. So from the athletic director to you, thank you for being awesome Panthers. All right, a little bit of a rundown for the things that you will be hearing this evening. I know for many of you, this is not your first awards banquet, but for some, maybe a little bit of introduction would be useful. You are going to hear students receiving different types of awards. There are several different levels, if you will. We have trophies that are sitting up here for certain awards, like most valuable performer or player, depending on the activity. That kind of is rather self-explanatory. We also have trophies here for what we call the Panther Award, which is a culmination of everything that we want a student athlete to be. If there was one person that we want to show as the model for what we want in our programs, it would be that person. So it could involve skill in the particular event, but it's also highly about character and who they are as a Christian person. And I know from experience that that's always a hard thing to distinguish as to who is the most deserving of that, because we are blessed with so many wonderful students that would be worthy of the Panther Award, but you'll be hearing those throughout the evening. You'll also see students receiving plaques like this that might be most improved or newcomer of the year, things like that, and those are rather straightforward as well. Students, if you receive either a blue trophy or a plaque, we're going to ask that you get your pictures taken with your fellow teammates for your event together, and then at the end of the evening, all together, all of the trophy award and plaque award winners will be taking a group picture behind me. You'll also hear awards for lettering. Each event has a criteria that must be met at the varsity level in order to letter for that year. Students that are getting their first letter of their career will also be receiving a GP Chenille cloth letter that goes on the letter jackets. And then you'll also hear students that are getting an award for participation. Maybe they did not meet the criteria for a letter, but we want to recognize their time and dedication to our activities in that capacity. All right, before we get into the actual presentation of our events, we're going to start things off with a nice video put together by Mr. Bauer.
Ladies and gents, this is the moment you've waited for. You've been searching in the dark, your sweat soaking through the floor. And buried in your bones, there's an ache that you can't ignore. Taking your breath, stealing your mind, and all that was real is left behind. Don't fight it, it's coming for you, running at you. It's only this moment, don't care what comes after. Your fever dream, can't you see you getting closer? Just surrender, cause you feel the feeling taking over. It's fire, it's freedom, it's flooding open. It's a preacher in the pulpit and your blind devotion. There's something breaking at the brick of every wall. It's holding all that you know. So tell me, do you want?
We light it up, we won't come down. And the sun can't stop us.
All right. Thank you, Mr. Bauer. Is there some way we can get that shared on Facebook or something? All right. Stay tuned. You can check it out again later. All right. Our first activity that we are going to be looking at this evening is the one-act play. My only note about that was, again, like last year, we were able to take the entire student body over to Watertown High School to watch the performance. I'm not sure exactly how many of the student body recognized what was exactly happening all the time, but to tell you all about it is the director, Mr. Martins.
Good evening. Okay. I didn't write anything down. So I thought I would just share with you a little bit about what we did this year. I was honored and privileged to work with 19 outstanding young men and women in the one-act play. When we finished a drama, whenever we last finished our last drama production, they said, the next time we do drama, we want to do something scary. Well, sometimes it's hard to find something scary. It all comes down to, I guess, I've seen some of our comedies that were pretty scary. Anyway, I read, and I was fortunate enough, I came across a script called Shuddersome, Tales of Poe. I was like, oh, Poe is kind of unique, so maybe we could give this a try. Well, I read it, and there were opportunities for things that we hadn't tried before, ways of communicating emotion and theater that we hadn't done before, and I thought, this will be a fun challenge. So I said, okay, we're going to do it. We read the script. I held auditions. We read through the script, and there was a little bit of confusion about exactly what was happening because it actually ended up being five short shows that just all transitioned into each other. So that's where some of the confusion came into, like what exactly was happening. Well, I saw the potential early on for what I thought we would be able to accomplish, and I am so thankful that this group listened, they fed and read off of each other, and they continued to push themselves to excellence, which included a first place in the region and a superior at the state contest. So congratulations. I'm going to introduce you to the cast, and I'm going to have them line up here. We'll go freshmen through seniors. One freshman, Gianna. Our sophomores, Bailey, Glenn, Lydia, and Austin. Yes, we occasionally include the tech people. Seniors on this side, I'll put the, freshmen is this way, okay. Juniors, Caleb, Sean, Caitlin, Sophie, and seniors, Bennett, Josh, Nathan, Michael, Hannah, Carly, Christina, Tyler, Brooke, and Emma. Okay, so I mentioned at the region we received first place. Technically, there's not a first or a second, but we did get first. also, I should mention at the region competition, we had a number of actors and actresses that receive individual awards. Each judge is able to give a certain number of awards, and it was shocking to me afterwards to find out that one judge had used all of her votes to nominate every single student up here, okay, minus the tech people, sorry, every single actor and actress for an individual award. So that was outstanding. That only left her, I think, two votes for other students from other schools. That was how impactful their performance at the region competition was. The other judges decided to spread some of the awards around a little bit, but we did end up with seven individuals that received outstanding awards at the region competition. And those individuals were Tyler Goins, Christina Hagberg, Carly Heil, Hannah Kratz, Michael Sell, Josh Weary, and Sophie Abrahamson. Congratulations. As I said, everyone was outstanding, and I didn't exactly know how they would decide or what they would do. Well, that's how that turned out. We continued on. We received a trophy. It looks something like that. I didn't bring it because I forgot. And we continued to the state competition. This is our 12th year participating in the region competition, and this is the seventh one-act play that has continued to the state. And this is our fourth one-act play that has received a state superior. And for that, we receive this lovely little plaque. At the state level, the judges can give out whatever awards they want as far as individual awards. And they decided that everyone in the show, in the cast, will get a medal for their performance, which is a state superior acting medal. So all the students on the stage. In addition, because the show received a superior at state, they will also all be receiving a medal that says State Drama Superior something, performance. Yeah, there we go. So they'll be receiving those two medals later, and the region award winners will be receiving their medals. I'll get them to you before the end of the evening is the goal. I decided to have them stand here. I'm just, again, so thankful and so proud to have the opportunity to work with them. We voted on awards for the end of the year. And I didn't know exactly what was gonna happen. I didn't know how it was gonna shake out, but I just let it fall how it may. And we have two special awards to give out, and the first one is the MVP. Marco Rubio. Anyway. Our MVP this year for the one-act play is Tyler Goins. Yeah, everyone was very valuable. But thank you, Tyler, for your work. And the next award is the Panther Award. Again, many deserving individuals for this award, and the way that it ended up working out, I'm kind of combining it with what I'm going to call a best debut performance, or at least best debut in one act play. And the Panther Award goes to Hannah Kratz.
Oh,
I want to take a moment. That's all the awards I have. But there are four individuals that have given 4 years to one act play. And that would include two state superior performances and multiple region medals. I think Josh, okay, well, we have, first of all, Nathan, who was in the play freshman year and then took over Tech for a number of years after that. So he has two state superior awards. Josh Weary, four or three region medals, and of course, two state superior awards. And Tyler Goins, two state superior, four region medals. And Christina Hagberg, two state superiors and four, something like that, region medals. We like to round up. We're in fine arts, we can do that. Anyway, without all of these seniors, 10 seniors participating in one act play, in particular these four that gave all 4 years to train and to be the leaders for the next generation of actors and actresses. Thank you. I cannot thank you enough. I am so excited to see the show. Take a look at the posters for the upcoming play production. It will be equally as amazing. Again, thank you for listening to me ramble. Thank you to you students. It was a privilege to direct the one act again. And I will get your medals later. Oh, wait, Hannah. Tyler.
All right, thank you, Mr. Martins. We are going to do one more activity before we break for supper. And we are going to do girls basketball. And before I introduce, I'm going to actually adjust this because I got yelled at in church for it always being so tall. Here to talk about the girls basketball season is Coach Foxen. Is this short enough?
Thanks, Coach Hoagley. All right, good evening. All right, insert long speech, but still shorter than Coach Hoagley's speech joke here. Okay, check. All right, first of all, a few thank yous that I want to say. To Carla and to Mr. Bauer, right, for faithfully driving the bus to our away games, which this season was kind of treacherous with all the winter weather. To Mr. Yeager and Mr. Hoagley for adjusting schedules, because again, weather. To Paige, Lydia, and Hannah over here, right, my faithful managers, you make my job really easy. Anything that I forget, they do it, basically. So they make me look good. And then to my assistant coaches, Coach Zek back there, Coach Cluck. Coach Cluck's over here, wave your hand. Okay. You guys are the true rock stars, right? They're my lifesavers. They're the ones I bounce my ideas off of, whether it's practices or games. They're the ones who tell me, no, that's stupid. Or, oh, you could probably go with that one. That's okay. Also, during practices, they're the ones that reminded me that, hey, you're pregnant, you should stop doing that. So I appreciate that, and so does my husband. Speaking of my husband, just wanted to say thank you, and just wanted to confess that I lied to you a few times this season. I would usually tell him that practice is done at 6:10, which is the scheduled end of practice time, and I would come home at about 7:15 almost every night, so sorry about that. Thanks for understanding. And then a final thank you, obviously, to you parents, right? I would like to do an experiment. I want to see how far away we can get a game and see how far the parents will actually drive. because they were always there. We go to Warner, parents are there. We go to Webster, parents are there. So thank you for all the support you showed your girls throughout the season, no matter what distance you had to drive, no matter what you had to do. So I appreciate it. Thank you very much. Thank you also for giving us the opportunity to coach these girls. It's awesome to see them improve as players, but it's even greater to see them improve and grow as young Christian adults. So I'd like to introduce the players. Players, I'm going to have you stay where you're at and just stand up and wave when I say your name, okay? All right. First, our eighth graders who came over to help us out from St. Martin's, Linnea Hayes, Kimberly Goins, and Daria Poor. You can stay standing, Linnea. All right. Our freshmen, Mariah Fish, Megan O'Farrell, Madeline Ramsey, Bryn Holman, Mally York, Natalie Ashton, Olivia Giovannitone, and then our manager, Paige Shore. Okay. Sophomores, Lizzie Konzenbach, Anna Bush, and then manager, Lydia Kratz. Juniors, Sherry Lee, Benita Menzengo, Lexi Charlemagne, Cameron Bulow, Miranda Bisek, Brooklyn York. Seniors, just kidding, Jocelyn Gash. Seniors, Kristen Kluck, Kendra Schlecht, Erica Gash, and then our manager, Hannah Kratz. Go ahead, give them a round of applause. Okay, and it looks like I didn't miss anybody, so you guys can sit down now. Thank you. All right, first I want to comment on the JV season. Our JV team was incredibly young. As you heard, we had three eighth graders on the team. A lot of the JV team happened to be freshmen. We had a couple of sophomores, a couple of juniors on the team. Some of them had never played basketball before but really wanted to learn. A strength of the team was their pursuit to get better every day, whether that was in practice or whether that was in a game. And their record doesn't necessarily highlight their improvement, right? But I do want to share two scores of the season for you guys. So the first score is from our first Florence Henry game. We played them in a tournament that was before Christmas. The JV lost. We scored 9 points. They scored 44 points against us. And that was away at Florence Henry. We just really struggled to run an offense that game. It was really tough. We played Florence Henry in the last game of the season, and the second half was outstanding. The Falcons, Florence Henry, scored about the same, so they scored 47 points. And instead of 9 points, we showed up and we scored 36 points. So that was an outstanding improvement from what they had done. Another game that stands out is their game up in Wilmot. Right, the team played, I call it a casual first half, right, but they rallied and showed relentless passion in the second half to make it an exciting and competitive game. JV players, take your passion with you in the off season as you work hard in preparation for next year. Then on the varsity side, we had many players returning from last season as well as the same coaching staff, and it was nice to hit the ground running with plays and strategies. The team improved throughout the season and also improved greatly from last season. So, in comparison to last season, they scored 7 more points per game. They worked for 5 more rebounds per game. They had 1 extra steal per game. They had 3 more assists per game. And they totaled 30 fewer turnovers than last year. And then for some of you interested seniors who played varsity as a freshman, this past season, compared to 4 seasons ago when you guys were freshmen, you had 150 fewer turnovers. I won't name who the coach was that year, but 150 fewer turnovers. I like that stat, so I had to give it to you. All right. So I'm going to sound a little cliche, but our season had its ups and downs. So we started our season in New Ulm, Minnesota, with a tournament, and we lost our first game to Northland. This is a team that we've never played before. That game was their 6th game of the season, and only our first. We ended up losing. The next day we played Evergreen, another team that we've never played before, and we fought hard and earned our first victory. Before Christmas, we had 5 games, and it seemed like every single game, somebody got injured, right? Our first game of the year, Erica got injured. Anna broke her foot. Miranda sprained an ankle. Kendra sprained an ankle. And to make matters worse, before the season even started, Cam had a bum shoulder, right? So we're already talking five girls before Christmas who are injured. So looking forward to Christmas break, we are ready to heal, and we are also enjoying a record of over 500, so we are 3-2 going into the Christmas break. When we came back from Christmas, we were healthy, except for Cam and Anna, right? But God had a sense of humor in all this, because with the weather, we had a couple of cancellations of several home games. Out of 19 games played this season, including our tournament at MLC and postseason, we played 15 of them on the road. 15 out of 19 games on the road. Even though we rarely enjoyed home court advantage, the girls put on dominant showings on other courts. Right. So just to remind you guys of a couple of them. I do not think that any of you will forget the triple overtime battle in Lake Preston. You showed immense perseverance that evening, and the coaches, I'm going to speak for all of us, are immensely proud of you. And then do you remember when we played at Waverly, where your second half rally startled a team which ended up going to the state tournament? That was pretty impressive. And then do you remember the rush of your playoff victory over Britt and Hecla, where it seemed like you ladies were reading each other's minds on the court? It was an incredible victory, right? A win in the playoffs is huge, and one that girls basketball hasn't seen in a couple of years. Right. We also had the opportunity then to face Warner, another team that ended up in the state tournament. Right. We had a tough game, but in the third quarter, right, we scored just as many points as they did. So that's a win almost for the third quarter. Right. Every game and every practice this season, you worked hard. When you were asked to run, you ran. When you were asked to work the offense patiently, you showed patience. When you were asked to follow the motto of the year, win the day, which means to improve daily, you were there to meet every challenge. You were a group of young ladies any coach would want to work with every day. And I'm going to speak for Coach Zach and Coach Cluck. We are super blessed to have been your coaches. And then I thought about one time when you guys were making fun of Coach Cluck. You remember that one time that during a drill he was hitting all the shots and you guys were practicing rebounding? Yeah, I don't think he appreciates that so much. Okay. All right. Before I begin with the awards, I just want to tell all the ladies, you guys do have awards to pick up in the science lab, so make sure you do that after everything is all wrapped up. All right. So, varsity letter winners for the 2018-2019 season are Kendra Schlecht, Kristen Cluck, Erica Gosch, Cam Bulow, Lexi Charlemagne, Miranda Biesek, Jocelyn Gosch, Bryn Holman, Hannah Kratz, and Paige Shore. And then for our other award winners, right, I'm going to announce your names first, and then I'm going to speak your praises and bow down to you as you come up here, and then I'll talk to you guys a little bit. Right? So first one is going to be the Panther Award. Right? Panther Award this season goes to Kristen Cluck and Erica Gosch. You guys can come on up. Alright, Coach Hugley already talked about the Panther Award. The Panther Award was voted on by the players, right? Kristen and Erica both show qualities for this Panther Award. Both of them lead in their own style, whether you're Erica being loud or Kristen being quiet. Right? They let their teammates know that they had high expectations for themselves and for their team as well. They both faithfully worked on their game outside of the season, whether that was in camps or basketball leagues or whether they were in the gym shooting around. In addition to the Panther Award, just wanted to highlight a few stats. Kristen, in her career at Great Plains, is seventh in steals with 124. She had 46 of those this season. She's eighth in career three-point percentage with 22.3%. And I'm going to tell her she wants to talk to Kendra, right? Because you just beat Kendra. She had 21.6%. So let her know. Records are made to be broken. Okay. Erica is ninth in career points with 382. She had 137 this season. and she's second in career three-point percentage with 28.57%. All right, congratulations, ladies. Our next awards tonight are Most Valuable Player and Defensive Player of the Year, both going to Kendra Schlecht. All right, Kendra, again, she was voted for both of these awards by her teammates. If I can describe her, she's a workhorse. Right, she's always drawing the best post from the other team on defense. Right, and we're always asking her to play somebody who's way taller than her or way thicker than her. And she always does a great job battling back. She always works hard in the paint to get past defenders. And like I said, Kendra's not always taller than everybody else around her, but she works hard at them. One thing I do remember from this past season, I remember when you were up in Wilmont against Bailey Juergens. Kendra Schlecht had the most beautiful up and under move. Right? It's one that I would record and show to all my children. Right? All right, congratulations, Kendra. Our next award is Most Improved Player, which goes to Jocelyn Gash. You're gonna leave. Okay. All right. So Jocelyn Gash, again, voted for by her teammates. Jocelyn is one of those players who loves to lift. The only person on the team who might like to lift more than her is Miranda. Right? And that's saying something. Right? Jocelyn gained confidence with every single game, every single practice throughout the season. And the turning point, I think, for her in the season was the game at Castlewood. And I think I've told you about this, right? It seemed like Jocelyn would cut across the lane, and there would be five aggressive Castlewood players around her. And we would get a pass into Jocelyn, and it would be like lightning speed, and she'd get her hands up like super glue. She'd catch it every single time. So, don't shake your head. All right. Anyways, Jocelyn is our most improved player from this season. Congratulations. All right, next award is Newcomer of the Year. This is for Bryn Holman. All right, Bryn is a freshman this year. She played on both JV and varsity. Last year, she came over as an eighth grader from St. Martin's to help us out, putting in some time at JV. Bryn was one of those players this year that I would play her at a post, I'd play her at a guard, and when I stuck her at a guard, I'd say, go ahead and shoot a three-pointer. And she'd always look at me and say, not gonna do it. And I always wondered why. Why don't you want to? Because I could see her make them in practices. But then I looked at her stats. She shot eight three-pointers in a game. She didn't make any of them, so that's probably why she told me she didn't want to shoot three-pointers. All right, we'll see what happens next year with that, though. All right, Bryn also has an incredible knack for finding a way to the ball on rebounds. And what's awesome about Bryn is once she gets the ball after a rebound, right, if it's an offensive rebound, she'll put it right back up. And it was always nice to see a freshman be so aggressive on varsity. I think she's one to look forward to watching in the next 3 years. Congratulations. Right, our last award for this evening is the Assist Leader Award. This award goes to Cam Bulow. Right, this award is the only award I give out solely based on stats. Right, and Cam's stats are impressive. Right, last season, Cam, you had 11 assists. And I remember in our preseason meeting, I talked to you and I said, I want you to make that pass. And I've called you Brett Favre multiple times. Right? This season, Cam increased that by 20. She's up to 31 assists on the season. If you keep that up, next year's going to be scary. In a sense, I want to say it, making baskets is easy, right? I can go in the driveway and I can shoot baskets. I can also practice my ball handling by myself. But when it comes to assists, that's not something you can practice in your backyard. That's something that you have. That's something that you work on in practice. That's something you work on in games. It's about seeing where your teammates are. It's about anticipating what your teammates are going to do. And it's just a really special talent to have, and Cam has it. So congratulations, Cam. I forgot to mention something about Cam. She's also got a couple records in her name. Cam has one more year left at Great Plains, so she has to hold on to a couple of these. Right, but right now, she's third in career three-point attempts. She's made 35 total. She's eighth in single free throw percentage, 65%. And she's currently first, so the best in Great Plains history, in career free throw percentages at 66.9%. Again, one more year to hang on to that one. I think you can do it. All right. If I could have my seniors stand up, please. Including Hannah Kratz, if she's here. All right. To you four especially, thank you for your 4 years of dedication to Great Plains basketball. Your hard work on and off the court does not go unnoticed by your coaches and your teammates. What's awesome about you guys is your hard work does not stop with basketball, but it also extends into the classroom. For this, the state of South Dakota recognizes each of you with the honor of being Academic All-State for your fantastic GPAs, as well as your dedication to basketball. Okay. One thing I want you guys to take away from the season is, once a Panther, always a Panther. And then something I hope that continues in the future is I hope that you guys join the prestigious alumni team and you get to come back over Christmas break and play against your teammates. All right? So, ladies, thank you for your 4 years of hard work. To all the girls basketball players, I hope you guys had fun this season. I know I did. Right? Hopefully you guys can come back. Something I want you guys to remember is don't let your growth end just because the last buzzer of the season sounded. Right? Win the day. And that includes every day of the summer. Thank you.
Don't go too far, Mrs. Foxen. Is she coming back? Grab her. Earlier this spring, it was announced that Mr. Foxen was accepting his divine call that he received to be a teacher at Fox Valley Lutheran High School. And so this summer, Mr. and Mrs. and Baby Foxen will be transitioning from Watertown to Wisconsin. And so on behalf of Great Plains Lutheran High School, and as your friend and fellow coach, it's been great to get to work with you. It's been great to watch you work with the JV boys of the past and the varsity and JV girls of the present. Thank you for your time and your dedication to basketball, and we wish you nothing but the Lord's richest blessings on your exciting future. Right. We are at the time of the evening to break for supper, so we will follow the normal customary procedure of entering into the commons from these doors right over here. There are serving lines that you can follow through, get some drink, and then come on back. We have two more events that we will do after the supper. So let's join in the common table prayer. Come, Lord Jesus, be our guest, and let these gifts to us be blessed. O give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good, for his mercy endures forever. Amen. All right, we're going to start with the student athletes. You can begin to make your way over, and then I will make my way and dismiss the rest of the tables as the line goes down.
I know some of us are just getting back to our seats, but the kids are already starting a trend to go and get more food, and please feel free to do that throughout the next several minutes. Even if we begin with the program, Sherry would appreciate if you continue to eat her food so she doesn't have leftovers. Thanks. All right, we are going to continue with our program here. If you feel like you need a little bit more food, please feel free to help yourself. They're going to leave the food sitting out for about 10 more minutes. Before we go on to our other activities, let's take a moment to thank Sherry and Carla and all the ladies for a wonderful supper. All right. This evening I get to wear a couple different hats. Some I'm very comfortable with and familiar with, some not so much. With the rescheduling of our banquets, our cheerleading coach, Coach Arndt, is not able to make it. She's out of state. And so I get to pretend to be her this evening. So we are going to start the second half with the cheerleaders. So I have a speech here written by her that I will present, and I will do my best to impersonate Coach Arndt to the best of my ability. Maybe not the voice. You know, I must say, this is probably the best group of cheerleaders I've ever had the honor of giving awards to. All right, here we go. Good evening. Let me start by saying, what a year. I am so proud to have coached this team and these girls. We started out rocky this year, and I was honestly scared for how this year was going to turn out. We had one returning senior, one junior whom I had never coached, and five freshmen. Let me tell you, that's not the group I expected. Even more unexpected was the determination and the excellence that this team has strived for and has accomplished. We had some firsts this year. Our first was a Panther cheer camp, which was a total success. We also did our first halftime routine. The girls worked so hard to perfect their routine, and it paid off big time. I can't begin to tell you how proud I am of these girls. I'm very excited for what will come next year. Now, on to the awards. I'm pleased to say that every cheerleader is receiving a varsity letter this year. Cheerleaders, you can pick up your letters and certificates in room 129 after this. Let's announce our cheerleaders. So ladies, why don't you stand when your name is read. Vanessa Steinmetz, Brooke Lamley, Grace Decker, Jenna Lindemann, Starla Hedman, Andrea Lubaya, Samantha Bendix, and JC Even. All right, now we'll go to the awards. Ladies, you can have a seat. Our first award is for a girl who was not on the team the day of our first practice. She was walking around and talking on her phone by the office, and I told her she should join cheer, jokingly. 10 minutes later, she walks into the room and says, "Hey, I'm gonna join, but I can't come to practice today." This girl has come so far and has worked her butt off to always improve herself. Our most improved award goes to Starla Hedman. Our next award is for a girl who I think is very quiet, but apparently my cheerleaders tell me otherwise. She was all around an amazing team player, always getting better, always leading, and always jumping in to try new things. Our MVP award goes to Jenna Lindemann. And our final award is for a girl who is a true-born cheerleader. She walked into my practice the first day, and I just knew she was going to be my go-to girl. It's very weird to read that, by the way. She is always the first to step up and help at practice, and is always leading the team, whether it be to call the cheers at games, getting everything ready, or just striving to be the best and helping others to be their best, too. She knows that we are only as good as our weakest link and makes sure that everyone is on the same page. This year's Panther Award goes to Samantha Bendix. I would like to thank all of the parents for all of your support. I know you have really lifted my spirits this year. They also went above and beyond to plan and run some team building activities so that I could focus on coaching. I will be forever grateful for the love you all have poured into this team. I look forward to working with all of you next season. Thank you all, Coach Arndt. And I would also like to express my gratitude for Coach Arndt, because obviously I'm not the one that could do cheerleading. So to each their own gifts, right? Very good. All right. Our final group that we are going to recognize this evening is boys basketball. So that's me as well. Sorry that you have to listen to the same voice all night. Some of my thank yous have already been stated, so I'll try to just do some of the new ones, perhaps, that I haven't mentioned. So the first one on my list, I don't know if she's still in here or not, but it's to my wife. Oh, yeah, she is. Thanks for letting me spend extra time with the boys away from the home. Probably should also thank our trusted fluff ball to keep us safe from all the intruders throughout the winter and all that fun stuff. Thanks to Nathan and all the tech guys. I know that's a repeat, but I really appreciate the ability that we have to live stream all of our home games. Thank you to my assistant coaches, and I'll get into this a little bit more in detail in a second, but to Coach Bauer, new to our coaching staff this year, who took care of the JV responsibilities and bounced a lot of ideas off of him throughout the school day specifically. Nothing against Coach Hansen, but you're not around as much. And just always appreciate working with other coaches, talking about philosophy, plays, and just absorbing as much information as possible. Also, thank you to both Mr. and Mrs. Bauer for hosting our team party over the Christmas break. So thanks for doing that. And then also Coach Hansen. We'll get into some more of the details with that in just a second. Before we introduce the players, maybe just a little bit of overview of our season. After football was over, I had a team meeting. Wanted to see how many boys were interested in playing basketball. I knew that the numbers would be high. I'd heard rumors that a lot of freshmen wanted to play basketball, which is great. I also knew that we were graduating a large number from the previous year, so I didn't know how that would all work out. And over 30 guys showed up to the meeting. And at that point, it was myself and Coach Bauer. And I knew there was a problem. How in the world is this going to work out? It's a great problem to have, but oh my goodness. So at the end of the thing, by the time we had our practices and some of the guys decided whether or not they really wanted to play, we had 28 guys in the gym on a regular basis playing basketball. What an outstanding number. Out of those 28, 15 of them were playing their first year of high school basketball. So either they were freshmen or they were trying it for the first time in their high school career, which is awesome. Lots of learning happening. It was amazing to think about how many bodies you can get moving in a gym like this when you have three coaches and you just look and listen. There is so much activity happening throughout the year. There is so much knowledge being imparted to the student athletes, and there were so many bodies that were constantly moving. It wasn't like a few people were practicing and the rest were sitting on the side. And I really appreciate the coaches for involving everybody so that they could all get opportunities to learn. Lots and lots of basketball was taught. I'm very thankful to the Lord for providing with us with a relatively healthy season. Unlike Coach Foxen's experience, we didn't have injuries every single game. Yeah, you're going to get your bumps and bruises and an ankle every once in a while. Of course, the big exception to that being Riley's football injury that prevented him from playing this year. But aside from that, pretty relatively healthy. We were young, really young. It was remarkable for me to think about how young we were at times and just realizing the process of learning how to compete at the level that the kids were at, whether that was C-team, JV, or varsity. And that learning took a long time. And I told the kids, if I could speed up the process, I would, but sometimes growing pains are just that. They're painful. And so I asked a big responsibility from a lot of guys that in other situations at their age probably wouldn't have had that responsibility thrust upon them. And then my last note about just the season was, I appreciate everyone's understanding of just the ridiculous February that we had. The kids knew that any time between 11 and 1, if my class instruction was interrupted by a phone call or a knock on my door, it meant bad things. It meant the game was canceled or postponed, and I don't have to wear my tie anymore, or something like that, okay? Just really, really, really frustrating to see the games get postponed and canceled and things like that. All right, let's break down the season by team. I'm going to introduce some of our players as we go through this. I will also, as I introduce some of these players, start to announce some of the awards. We certainly have the trophies and plaques that we've been hearing about from other ones, but we also have maybe some lower level or goofier awards that are bestowed upon the student athletes. An aspect of the game, if you will, that is important, but it's not something that we'd give a trophy out for necessarily. So I hope that it makes sense as we go through this. And for these awards and the awards that we will be giving out at the end here, all of them are voted on by both the coaches and the athletes themselves. So with the C team, let's introduce our guys. When I read your name, stand up and stay standing till the whole group has been read off. Freshman on the C team, Jackson Coles, Elijah Grahams, Robbie Goins, Lucas Yeager, Deion Warren, Joe Erickson, Ryan Kuhlman. Sophomores, Nolan Hansen and James Kim, and junior, David Lubaya. This is your C team. All right, guys, you can have a seat. Leading the C team this year was Coach Hansen. We'll get to that in a second. Many of you remember Coach Hansen because it wasn't that long ago that he was sitting over here with the kids. I don't think Coach Hansen was offended if I am honest and say he was not my first choice to be the leader of our C team. He was not my second or third or fourth. Well, I don't remember how far I went down the list. There were other people that I tried, and God was just guiding us with no's until I got to the right person. And let me tell you, we got the right person. I was certainly a little bit unsure if someone of his age would be able to separate, I'm the coach, you're the athlete. We're no longer teammates, we're not buds, I'm the coach. It took me about 5 minutes to realize that that was a ill-conceived fear. Coach Hansen, your professionalism, your demeanor, your basketball knowledge was evident from day one. The C team boys learned a lot, they grew a lot. As your former coach, it was really fun to see you on this side of things, realizing the frustrations of this side of the sideline. There is nothing in your control. Deion makes the shot or he misses the shot, right? And so it was really fun to see you grow. And so I thank you for your time. College kids be doing a lot of stuff with their free time, and you dedicated several hours a night on the road trips to being part of our team. I appreciate your efforts. I hope you'll consider doing it again next year if your schedule allows for it. Thanks, Coach Hansen. With the scheduling and the reschedules, the cancellations, it affected every single level, but I think the C team suffered the most because of it. We had tried to move things around, and when a opponent got a rescheduled, whether it was against us or against a different opponent, they would call us and say, yeah, we can't make it anymore because we have to be in a different city. And that's just the way that it went. We've never had a situation like this in my time, in the 5 years I've been here, where we had a dedicated C-team squad with a dedicated C-team coach. We've had C-team games in the past, but that was just the JV players that maybe didn't play as much in the JV games, and we let them have some more playing time. This is extremely frustrating. I think we went a stretch of like 3 weeks without a game, if I remember right, C-team guys. We even went to a place to play an opponent, and they forgot that we were supposed to play them, and we had to come back without playing that game. That counts as a win, right, Coach? I need to learn how that works. You show up, and they quit. All in all, I believe the C-team's record was 3-5. It was great to see them compete, great to see them have fun. I saw 10 guys at the beginning of the season in late November that were individuals. At the end of the year, they were a team. They learned each other. They learned each other's strengths and weaknesses. They got on each other's nerves every once in a while. That's what family does. But they grew together, and I'm very proud of their season. On to the JV team. We'll introduce the student athletes that played JV this year. Our freshmen, again, stand, please. Gavin Dornbush, Connor Canas, Trent Lean, David Sell, Sam Hansen, and here we have a couple awards that Sam was voted upon. Mr. Spin Cycle for best post moves. I guess that's the only one. And our last freshman, Ethan Jenstead. Sophomores on JV, Pierce Holeen, Logan Lausing. Logan received the Sniper Award for Best Shooter. Martin Rosh, who received Mr. Nat with a G for the most annoying on-ball defender. And Colin Yeager. And we also had a senior on JV, Jerry Chen. These were the JV boys. You guys can have a seat. I'm very thankful to Mr. Bauer for his work with the JV team. It's just a great opportunity to see someone who has great basketball experience at different levels get to work with these guys. Very similar story to the C team. I saw a group of players that were individuals at first, coming from different grade schools, different experiences, that had to learn to play together as a team. And they often competed against players that were older than them. Let's just leave it at that. Teams that were primarily sophomores and juniors, and maybe even some seniors that played JV. And we were trying to compete with them, with primarily freshmen and sophomores. They were very competitive as the season went on. As they learned their plays, as they learned their skill sets, as they grew as players, that was one of our themes throughout the entire season. We adopted the theme, Watch Us Grow. And that really changed the whole mindset. C team, JV, varsity, we all grew. And JV was a great example of that. They received, I believe it was 3 wins on the year, towards the latter end of the season, as they started to gel. They also had a couple of close losses, learning how to execute in late game situations. Very, very excited for this group of young men. The potential that they have is certainly something I hope comes to fruition through hard work and preparation for the seasons to come. That's all I have for the JV. Thanks for the hard work this year, JV boys. Sometimes people ask me, what's the biggest difference between coaching girls and boys basketball? And the more I do this, the more it's quite simple. A freshman girl might be very similar to the type of athlete that she is when she's a senior. Freshman boys, not so much. They change a lot from freshman to senior year. They mature, they get stronger, they get more athletic. And I can't wait to see where some of our young guys grow. I think that very much summarizes the varsity level this year. Playing against teams, very, very, very talented teams, teams that went to state, teams that won state, with a bunch of players that hadn't ever been on varsity before, for many of them. When I think of the season, you know, you can look at the record, and certainly it was not the record we wanted, but I always paused at certain times throughout the year, and I asked myself, what were these guys doing 12 months ago, just a year? Where were they? The answer for most of them was something like maybe JV, maybe back of the bench JV last year, or playing grade school. And now they're being asked to play varsity basketball. So I'm very, very proud of all 28 guys, but especially the guys I'm about to present to you now. Our athletes on varsity. Some of these will be repeats. Freshmen, David Sell, Sam Hansen, Ethan Jenstead. Sophomores, Logan Lausing, Martin Rosh, Colin Yeager, Andrew Heil, who received a couple awards, Mr. Handles, Best Dribbler, Mr. Vice Grip, Triple Threat. Yeah, me too. Nathan Bean, who was voted Mr. Clean, the best on the boards, on the glass, the best rebounder. Our juniors, Asher Lindemann, who won Mr. Floorburn, Chris Schlecht, Joe Tischer,
Mr. Box Out, and Mr. Encourager, and our seniors, Charlie Beck, who won Mr. Black and Blue, and Riley Reisman, who won Future Coach. Your varsity boys. You can have a seat, guys. Before I go too much farther, I'd like to also recognize my two managers this year, Stephanie Van Veen and Kylie Lausing. Great work this year. We were a little bit short-staffed with just two managers this year. You can stand. We'll embarrass you. But thank you, ladies, for your work. Stephanie, specifically, for taking a freshman on and showing her the ropes. Kylie, for learning things so well. Look forward to more managerial duties next year. Thanks, ladies. A couple of our opponents towards the end of the year, even a couple of coaches came up to me and said, how you doing? You all right? You hanging in there? As if it was like a pity question. And it's fine. I understand this, but the record is what it is and stuff like that. But my answer was every time was exactly the same. I'm great. You know why? Because my guys are giving me everything they have every single night. Every practice, we're growing. Every game, we're growing. What more can a coach ask than everything that his athletes have? If our final score at the end of the game is lower than the other team, then we'll go back to work and we'll try to do it better the next time. And that's exactly the demeanor that our team had. If you only came to practices, if you never checked online for scores, if you never went to a game, you'd have had no idea that we didn't have any wins this year. You'd have none, because they just kept on working. They fully adopted the growth mentality and said, I'm going to walk off the court at the end of practice better than when I stepped on the court. And that goes so far. And I really credit our coaching staff and our leadership on the team for adopting and accepting that's the mentality. Not that we need to lose all the time. We're here to compete. But the process of winning is a lot of little steps. And I truly believe we have taken a lot of those little steps already this year, considering how young our team is. All right, so let's announce our letter winners for this year. Many, many individuals receiving their first. We'll go from the top down. Charlie Beck receiving his second. You can stand. Riley Reisman, Joe Tischer, Chris Schlecht, Asher Lindemann, Andrew Heil, Nathan Bean, Colin Yeager, Logan Lausing, Sam Hansen, and Ethan Jensted. Your letter winners for 2018-2019. At the end of this, all boys basketball players, you can go into my classroom and pick up your stuff. It's on the desks. Look for your name. All right, I'd like to take one moment to pick on my three seniors. And we'll start with Jerry. Is Jerry here? Stand up, Jerry. This was Jerry's first year at GPL, his first year being a Panther. He was at a different school in South Dakota where you did play basketball. Correct. So it wasn't your first time playing basketball in South Dakota. Jerry was on the JV team and provided great energy, and was great to have you as a Panther. You're a wonderful young man. I'm glad you were on our team. Thanks, Jerry. Charlie. Charlie's been a supremely significant player for our varsity team for the last 2 years. He's been a Panther for all four of his years here. My first memory of Charlie, and this is so reminiscent of just the type of athlete he was, when I was reffing the grade school basketball tournament and he was a player for St. Martin's, he went after a loose ball and ended up underneath the entire curtain and almost underneath the stage as he dove for it. And I asked him, as I was the official down on that end, I said, are you all right? And he just looks at me, he's like, yeah, I'm fine. That's Charlie. Maximum effort, sometimes out of control, but always giving maximum effort. And that is one of the things I will always appreciate about Charlie. The big difference for Charlie this year was the role that he played on varsity was so much different. Last year, he was part of a group of seniors that did things, and Charlie was a part of that, but he wasn't one of the main people. This year, he was the only part of that piece that was left. And so his role certainly changed. Charlie was chosen by our team to be a captain, and he certainly was a great leader for us, a quiet leader, but that's a great way to lead, too, by leading by example. The
probably the best reiteration of the type of athlete that he was I think it was in Lake Benton, Elkton, the game, where he took a charge. He got a knee to the face. And he took a charge. He got the call. Comes walking down the court, and there might have even been a timeout, and he comes to the sideline, and I said, "You got that knee in the face, didn't you?" He's like, "Yup." Stinks to be a short post, but I think that reiterates the type of mentality that Charlie had. Charlie, I thank you for your hard work. I thank you for your leadership, and we'll miss you. And Riley. Riley came to GPL without a lot of grade school basketball experience. I remember his freshman year, he tried it. Success? Not so much. He was even shorter back then, believe it or not. But he kept on trying. He kept on working hard. And I don't remember exactly if it was between your summer of your freshman to sophomore year or sophomore to junior year, but there was a time when Riley was wondering if he should continue with basketball. And I was not his coach at the time, so I had no skin in the game, but our conversation went something like this. I said, "Riley, you know, in a school this size, good athletes, they do three sports. They just play. Even if it's your third favorite or the sport you're the third best at compared to the other ones, be on the team. There are going to be guys on the basketball team that are going to be dependent upon by you to be on the football team and the track team, and so reciprocate that." And I'm so glad you stuck it out. Because in a time when kids decide, "Oh, I'm not as good at a sport, so I'm not going to do it," you did it. And you were a great example to our young men. I was really looking forward to Riley's senior year because he was stuck behind several guards last year when he was a junior in the class. Ahead of him had a lot of guards. He didn't get a lot of floor time last year, but he worked really hard in practice, and I was really excited to see how that would translate. Told myself I was going to get through this. Obviously, God had a different plan for Riley. You never want to see a kid get injured. Especially a senior. Riley, you set such a wonderful example to our young boys, the guys that look up to you. When God puts struggles and obstacles in our life, we don't whine, we don't complain. I'm sure there were moments, maybe with your parents back home, when it was hard, but not once did you show that around the kids. You made the best out of the opportunity you had. You were a wonderful teammate. You showed a great example of what it means to be a Panther athlete. And I'm so glad you made that layup. For those of you that weren't here, he got an uncontested layup to start a game, and he decides to do a reverse. Riley, I wish that circumstances were different, but I thank you for being you. I thank you for being one of our leaders. And I thank you for your dedication to Panther basketball. I have one small recognition to give before we give out the trophies. A statistical accomplishment was achieved this year that I wasn't expecting, and this individual probably is not expecting it either. We keep stats, and we list up to the top 10 performances for certain statistical categories for each major stat in basketball, as well as career things, and we had a single season accomplishment this year. With 122 rebounds, the ninth best season of all time, Joe Tischer is in the record books. Okay, let's give out some hardware. Our Newcomer of the Year Award. Wow, did we have the candidates. Lots of opportunities, lots of individuals that made an impact. We're going to give out two Newcomer of the Year. Both of these young men had great impacts on our team from day one. I'm excited for their future. Both of these young men are freshmen. Our Newcomers of the Year, Sam Hansen and Ethan Jenstedt. Next is most improved. On a team where growth is the theme and the need to grow is evident, most improved can be very difficult. The winner of our most improved saw his role increase greatly this season. He also needed to take time to learn what it takes to be a consistent player at the varsity level. It was fun to see him realize the different ways that he can impact a game even when the ball's not going in the hoop. This year's most improved player is Nathan Bean. Our defensive player of the year and MVP are the same individual. Our defensive player of the year goes to a young man who is a steady leader for our defense. He gave maximum effort for this team, and his defensive effort has earned him this award. The MVP award also goes to him. He was one of our leaders. Aside from the defensive accolades already mentioned, he gave the team a rare thing, experience. His experience usually put him in the right position to make things happen. A good chunk of his points came at the back end of our press break. This year's Defensive Player of the Year and Most Valuable Player, Charlie Beck. And the Panther Award. The Panther Award goes to a young man who used his role as a leader quite well. He was very vocal in practices and games, encouraging the team to succeed. Even when he was on the bench, he was one of the first ones on his feet, cheering for a teammate who did something well. Yes, I watched the film to watch how the bench performs. I can't give just one Panther Award out this year, because another is just as deserving. This young man was a leader unlike anyone I have ever had the privilege to experience in my coaching career. God put an obstacle in his way. I'm sure the days in private were tough, and coping with his injury was not easy, but he set a tremendous example of how to accept God, that God's plans are bigger than our plans, and that God's plans are always perfect. Our Panther Award winners, Riley Reisman and Joe Tischer. That's the number of boys that are coming back to play basketball next year. Sometimes people increase their role on a team because of graduation, as many experienced this last offseason. That's not going to be the case this next year, with so many people returning. What I'm going to say here is a reiteration from our postseason meeting. Internal competition is a wonderful thing. It is not selfish. When younger players look at players that have a bigger role on a different team than them, and say, I want that spot, I'm going to work for it, that makes us better. And when that individual says, no, you're not, because I'm going to get better and keep my spot, that makes us better. I'm very much looking forward to seeing what these guys look like next winter. So guys, go to camps, go to open gyms. We talked about quantity and quality. Don't just go and spend some time, get up a few shots and say you worked out. Work hard, work on your skills, ball handling and shooting. All over the place. Universally as a program, we need to improve on all of that. My goal for next year is that we don't give up as many points as this year, and then we score more. How's that for coaching insight? Everybody's going to get a fair look come the end of November. Just because you're on a certain team this year doesn't guarantee you a single thing next year. You have to go and earn it, and that's the way it should be. Bottom line, I expect all three levels, C, JV, and varsity, to be putting a much more complete product on the court, next winter. The darkest days are behind us. We've grown, let's continue to grow, and let's experience the fruits of that growth next year already. All right. The final thing I have, Mr. Foxton's coming to the front. the announcement was that we had a four-year cheerleading accomplishment, which was Vanessa for all 4 years. I wasn't aware of that. So congratulations for a wonderful career, Vanessa. Okay, as we wrap things up here, I have a couple announcements to share from the Booster Club for you. First of all, they wanted to thank all of you that volunteered throughout the season to help with the concessions. I know that was extremely difficult as games kept on moving and your schedules matched sometimes and didn't match with others. Thank you for using the sign-up genius. Thank you also to Mrs. Miller for sending out reminders when we were a little bit short-staffed. Please continue to look for opportunities to help us out next year. The Booster Club would also like to invite more people to come to our meetings. We meet a few times a year. The next one is scheduled for Wednesday, May 22nd. That's right after graduation, if my memory serves me correct. And the last thing from the Booster Club, perhaps some of you saw it on the doors as you came in, but we are starting a bit of a fundraiser, I suppose, if you will, to purchase sideline chairs, customized sideline chairs for our volleyball and basketball teams. That will have school emblem on it and say GPL in some capacity. So we're having a fundraiser for that. If you're looking for information on that, there are flyers on the white table as you head out into the commons. You can certainly ask myself, Mr. Bauer, or anyone else on the Booster Club about what that all entails. Just a reminder for all of our students that got trophies and plaques, we're going to meet right back here for a picture. And then also, everybody make sure that you go to the appropriate classrooms to pick up your certificates and your pins and your letters and all that stuff. And the last one I have, with the tough scheduling in February, we were not able to distribute our varsity basketball posters to all the families as well as we wanted to. Both the boys and girls posters are also on that same white table out in the commons. Parents, if you don't have one in your household, please take one. We have lots of them. Please keep that as a memory on the season. That's all the announcements that I have written down here. I know it's been a little bit of a longer than normal schedule here, so thank you for your time. Safe travels to all of you, whether that's short or long distance. Thanks for everybody that tuned in online, and thank God for all the blessings that he's given to our student athletes and to our school. Until next time, thank you. I couldn't get through Riley's thing. I told myself I could do Riley, I could get it done. Nope, couldn't do it.